Tune in this week to episode 5 in our Developer and Identity series with Christos Matskos. This time we're going to talk about securing your code with Pulumi and Terraform. So tune in. Welcome back to episode 5 of the Identity for Developer series with Christos Matskos. Christos, welcome back to the building again.
Surprise!
I know, you're back. Awesome. So today we're continuing this series. We're talking about identity for developers. We did some cool infrastructure as code last time. We're going to continue the infrastructure as code theme today with Pulumi and Terraform.
Yes. Ooh. People will think I'm stuck with Key Vault and Azure Active Directory, but it is the way to go. It is.
So we're going to talk about Pulumi and Terraform. I'm a big Terraform fan. Mm-hmm. I also do some work with Pulumi. Mm-hmm. They're a little bit competitors, so hopefully they're both not watching this, but yeah.
Well, whichever tool you like to double, we showcased Bicep and ARM, but there are a lot of companies out there that work with third-party tools, and we want to support them. And it turns out that there is a way, again, to integrate Key Vault in your pipeline. So if you are using Terraform, if we quickly switch on to my laptop, you'll see I have a demo here with Terraform. Very basic. Again, it just does a deployment with SQL.
Oh, we love SQL.
Yeah, I love my SQL. It's a great example because it takes a username and a password and it requires that. And therefore, it's easy to showcase. Not the easiest because it's slower, but it's easy. So the main Terraform file here has a number of things. In fact, we're also using Azure Active Directory to secure our backend. So if you work with Terraform, you know that you can have a backend. And in this instance, we're using Azure Storage. The nice thing is that we can authenticate with Azure Active Directory by using a specific tenant. So no credentials there to share. And then the next component here, the magic happens with our Azure Key Vault resource, which we again instantiate. And then we pass it around and say every time we need to get a secret, we just want to reference that Key Vault. And down here, in a very similar manner as with Bicep, we have a get Key Vault secret command, which allows you to grab the Key Vault secret and pass it into your template. Okay. So in the variables, we never ever have to put any sensitive information, and Terraform just works. So if I were to run this, we'll let it run, and while this one is running, we'll switch to the Pulumi demo, so we don't have to wait in the background. So not terrible.
And I think it's really good that you put the state file, the backend, into Azure Storage, because a lot of times people will just allow the backend to run locally, which we don't want to do, because it'll be in your source control. Again, another bad place to put that, because that has all the infrastructure information that you need for your deployment. So you don't want to do that. So that's good you have it in Azure Storage. There's all sorts of ways you can also lock down storage even further through networking and routing that we're not going to go into today. But definitely something for people to look at. And actually, I believe we probably have a blog we can put in the show notes about that. So I will make sure that happens for everyone out there, because you can lock down the storage even further.
Absolutely. So Terraform is planning, doing its thing. If there were any issues with permissions again, it will show up here as part of the plan. So we don't have to worry about that. I will switch to Pulumi. And again, in a very similar manner, Pulumi allows us to do some integration. In fact, this was the one that really had me going for a while, because I wanted to use the Azure Native, the new provider from Pulumi. The previous one was built on top of Terraform. And also, they didn't have full integration with all the services. The new Azure Native APIs are calling directly into Azure REST APIs, and they have better integration. However, nobody has thought about how to secure secrets in the way that I was trying to do it. And therefore, it took a little bit of back and forth. Now, I'm using .NET. You could be using TypeScript if you want, or you could be using the other languages that they support.
Like Golang, which is one of my favorites.
And we have Azure Identity and Azure SDKs for Go now. And here, because I'm using .NET, I can write a little bit more verbose code. So I do have a get Key Vault secret method, but you'll notice that the big difference with all the other solutions, and this was the one that had me thrown on a little bit, is the fact that you have to tap into Azure SDKs. So there's no way for Pulumi to natively pull the secret from Key Vault. So you need to use code for that. But since you're writing code anyway, you're writing the code for that. So we use the default Azure credentials, and then we grab a token. Now you need to explicitly also say that I need a token for Key Vault. All the other things worked out of the box magically, whereas this one you need to be a little bit more explicit and then say which Key Vault do you need to use. And then you just pull the secret, and this function actually passes the secret back into our code. So when I'm creating a new SQL server here, what I do is I'm calling my methods, and then I await them because they're async, and I pass the information back. Again, if I were to come into our Pulumi and say Pulumi preview, if I remember correctly? Yes, good. And also you can use Key Vault to store secrets natively for Pulumi secrets as well, which is another component on top of the real-time runtime pulling the secrets at deployment. So Terraform shift completed. There were no changes, but I wanted to prove that this works. And while Pulumi is running, I want to showcase how the actual GitHub action works, because that's the key, right? I mean, so far we've been showcasing locally running, but this same exact action here, we're setting everything up, we're building the code, and then the second part is a deployment, and we're using the Pulumi CLI, we download it, we sign into Azure login using a service principal for now, and then we are using the artifacts that we compiled before to do a Pulumi app.
Okay.
You'll notice there's a slew of secrets down here and information that Pulumi needs, but using either the mass identity agent that we have for GitHub actions or the federated identity, you should be able to eliminate these.
Okay, cool.
But this is the function. In fact, I have a GitHub repo that runs that in production so you can see it running. But technically, being able to verify that it works locally and then push it onto GitHub is fantastic. Again, no secrets anywhere.
Cool. So we could run that in a dev container, test it locally, push up to GitHub, and use that action to deploy into Azure.
Exactly.
Perfect. Wonderful. Well, that was pretty easy. So we've secured our secrets using Terraform. We've secured our secrets using Pulumi. And for those of you watching, if you want to go see how to secure your secrets using Bicep and Arm, check out our previous episode. All right. So we've secured infrastructure as code end-to-end.
Yes.
Awesome. Into Azure. So thank you, Christos, for showing us how to deploy infrastructure as code to Terraform and Pulumi today, because we have customers that use both, especially if they're multi-cloud.
Yep.
We can deploy that locally into a dev container. We can test it. We can go into Azure, full CI/CD, abstract all those secrets.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Cool. So for everyone watching today, tune in next time, and we're going to continue our series on identity for developers.